Hello, welcome. Thank you all so much for joining me here. My name is Charity and this message is for Leo. So this is going to be a you and them love reading. I'll have your cards on the one side and your person's cards on the other. This is someone you are connected to energetically, romantically, someone that you're thinking about, and someone who is thinking about you. I'm recording this message for the energies of January, but I ask these readings to be timeless and give you something you need to hear when you need to hear it. And Happy New Year's to everyone. Okay, let's get started. Spirit, we got the heart of the matter here already for Leo. It jumped out. What is going on in Leo's daily life could be affecting this connection. What is going on in the daily life? What is happening in their heart space? How are they feeling about the person? What intentions do they have towards this connection? And what is a potential outcome in the near future? Or whenever you're meant to hear this message. Two more cards, Spirit. Two more cards. And one more. Oh, that's a lot of cards. I am just going to go ahead and take the one that was face up. Okay. Let's get the cards for your person. We'll get into this. Spirit, what is the heart of the matter for Leo's person? What are they thinking about this connection right now? What are some things going on in their daily life could be affecting the connection? Feeling in their heart? What are they feeling for their Leo? Spirit, what are they feeling? What are they feeling for their Leo? What intentions do they have towards this connection? And what is a potential outcome in the near future? Or whenever you're meant to hear this message. One more, Spirit, one more card. Wow, we got two, but I'm going to go ahead and take them because they are reflecting two cards that are on your side. Something is coming together here for you, Leo. And on the bottom of the deck, we have the Ten of Cups for how your person is feeling about you. This is someone who is thinking about you and feeling like you could make them really happy. Like the two of you could make each other really happy, and it's a happiness that could last. So heart of the matter, the way you're feeling overall and thinking about this connection, we have the Four of Wands. This is a beautiful connection getting into a love reading. Aries energy could be significant, but this is wanting to see someone more, be around them more, maybe take things to the next level, get a little more serious. I feel like you might know who this person is, the way the two people are looking at each other. I mean, we do have a Fool jumping in. You could have somebody new coming towards you, but I do feel like there's this sense, like you know who's on your mind, and the two of you are thinking about each other a lot. I feel like you're thinking about each other a lot at night, and like if you see each other during the day and maybe you're not talking about how you're feeling, I feel like it comes up for both of you at night. That's just the way that it's coming to me here. And for your person, the heart of the matter is the Chariot. Cancer energy could be significant, but this is someone wanting to make things happen. This is someone who knows how they feel and they want to do something about it. They want to see where this can go. They want to see what can happen. They have very warm feelings for you. And the Chariot to me has a lot to do with kind of like a healing energy, taking the time to work through your things. So you're ready for the next step. You're ready for the next move. And a lot of times we can have a lot of feelings for one another, be ready to go. But sometimes if we still have things that are happening in our heart, things that maybe from the past that we haven't fully processed or dealt with or healed from, it can be hard to take the next step. But when you get the Chariot, it's like someone's taken the time to do that inner work and they do want to take that next step with you. And I feel like you want that too. In your daily life, you've got the Hermit. Virgo energy could be significant, but you could be feeling kind of on your own right now, Leo. You could be feeling kind of an independent energy, sort of some deep thinking. It's kind of interesting as we begin the year. I just turn my phone onto airplane mode so nobody calls me. As we begin the year, we have a few retrogrades going on, but as we get a little further into January, planets go direct. So you could be feeling a little introspective as the year begins, thinking about the people in your life, thinking about how you feel, thinking about how you want to move forward. But as things progress this month, things start happening. And you definitely have some things that are going to be happening here, Leo. I love this for you. For your person, for their daily life, we have the Four of Pentacles. They're thinking about you. They're holding on, and they're holding on tight. The Four of Pentacles can be when somebody is a little guarded, and they hold on almost too tight. Like they're afraid to let go. They're afraid that something might not work out. They're maybe afraid to make a move, but it's amazing how sometimes someone can like you so much and hold on to those feelings for so long and yet be afraid to make a move because they don't know what the outcome is. They don't know what's going to happen. They don't know, you know, maybe if you feel the same. And we have Capricorn energy here, could be significant, but this person is definitely thinking about what to do next. And I'll tell you why in a second. But in your heart space, you've got the Page of Coins. Could be someone that you're connected to, you know, through friends, work, studies, something like that. It may be even a friend of a friend kind of energy. But it could be the two of you, you know, with this Page of Pentacles in your heart space, could have like more of a like there might be a friendship, you might be see each other, you might like each other, but it's possible nobody's spoken up yet. And I do feel like you're interested that in taking a step, seeing where things can go, but I feel like it's like you're not going to rush this. The Page of Pentacles can be kind of tentative, can kind of spark things up maybe in a more casual way and see where they're going to go. So someone could be wanting to spark something up with you, or you could be feeling that way, or you're both feeling this about each other. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy there. It's your person in their heart space has the Page of Swords. So with the Four of Pentacles and the Page of Swords, this is someone who likes you, thinks about you in ways that you might not even realize. And with the Page of Swords, might be checking you out when they think you aren't looking, might be looking at your social media, you know, might be asking people about you, trying to find out, is Leo interested? You know, if I did make a move, would they want something to happen? That Page of Swords can be a little bit of sneaky energy sometimes, you know, somebody who really is doing their homework and wanting to know that if they reach out to you, they don't want to be rejected. They don't want to look like, you know, they don't want to be embarrassed. If they like you and they think you like them, but they're not really sure, it's like they don't want to be embarrassed. This person kind of wants to know. But when you get swords in the heart space, sometimes that, because swords are all about thoughts and thinking, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius energy can be significant. But when you get those swords there, it's somebody who is maybe overthinking their feelings. And it's easy to do, especially when you don't know how the other person is feeling. But your intentions here are the full energy, Aries, also Aquarius for me as a reader, but the full energy is a brand new beginning. It is to stop overthinking, to stop worrying, and just to take a leap. Be ready to try something new. Be ready for something exciting. Be ready to have some fun and just see what can happen. The Fool takes a leap when they don't know what the outcome is going to be. And I feel like you're thinking about this person. They're thinking about you. Maybe neither of you are really knowing what the other is feeling, but I think you're ready to see where this can go, Leo. And the Fool sometimes takes things one step at a time. And with that Page of Pentacles, you might want to do that. But there's a lot of energy. There's definitely some cleared karma. I feel like you really have processed and worked through some things from the past because the Fool is free spirited. The Fool is ready to go. And it's a new beginning. Could be someone completely brand new. But I do feel like this is someone, whether it's new or not, they have their eye on you and have been thinking about taking a step or doing something for a minute now. I just have to say it with that Page of Swords, because like they are wanting to know. And their intentions, I love this for you, are the Eight of Wands. So this person definitely wants to go for it with the Chariot, holding on kind of tight, maybe overthinking with that Page of Swords, you know, their next move, what to do. But with the Eight of Wands, this is an energy of somebody just reaching out and going for it. It can be impulsive. It can take you by surprise. It can come in kind of quick, but it's a positive energy, and it's an energy that can go someplace with that Eight of Wands. It's forward movement. It's like the two of you, if you open up and say that, wow, I've been thinking about you, and they say, man, I've been thinking about you too. And then all of a sudden, you know, you're talking for hours. That's the kind of energy, the Eight of Wands. And that's what this person wants with you. It can be an energy of somebody wanting to move things kind of fast. Sagittarius energy could be significant. And if that's what you want, you know, that's fine. But never let yourself be rushed. You know, you gotta be comfortable with the way things go, the way things move forward. So your potential outcome cards, I just love this. I feel like you've had a few tough readings, Leo, and I love the way this energy is coming together. It's like, it's almost like it's been building up for something really positive to happen to you. And I feel like you've been putting the positive energy out there, because your potential outcome is the Page of Cups, the Magician, and the Sun. And the Sun is your card. That's Leo energy. It's good news. And with that Page of Cups, that is some flirtation. That is some fun. That is some playful new energy. This is somebody, you know, kind of smiling at you. I mean, that's the energy of a wink, you know, a flirty little text. Like, I love the Page of Cups for that, because it's lighthearted. It's somebody who might not be ready to think all the way down the road, but they are thinking about that a little bit, and I'll tell you why in a second. But they definitely want this little I don't know, this flirtatious fresh start to see where it can go. And Leo, it has to do with something that you are doing. Oh, also Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces could be significant with that Page of Cups. For the Magician, I get Aries and Gemini, me as a reader. There is something that is coming towards you, something positive, something really, really happy. The Sun is one of the most positive cards in the tarot deck, and I feel like you deserve it. I feel like you deserve some good times, some good news, some good energy, and it's really positive good news in love and in things in your life. And it has to do with something that you're doing to make this happen. Leo, you might not even realize it, but the Magician manifests the next step. They manifest what is coming towards them. And by manifesting, it means that the energy that you put out comes back to you. And if you've been putting out this positive, warm energy with the Sun and the Page of Cups, opening your heart, ready for love, ready for good times, like you are drawing that back to you. Now, your person's potential outcome, kind of interesting what we have here. We have the Ten of Pentacles and the High Priestess. And then we have the Page of Cups and the Page of Pentacles. So new beginnings all over the place. If this is someone that you know well, there are some really positive new beginnings. They're definitely taking some steps towards you, because in their potential outcome, they've got the Page of Cups, Page of Pentacles, asking to get together, asking to see you, flirting. But here, first of all, they have the Ten of Pentacles right next to the High Priestess. The Ten of Pentacles is about long-term commitment. The Ten of Pentacles is the person you really want to be with, person you want to spend some time with, the person you even feel like you could have a long-term commitment, even marriage, if that's something that you're interested in. That Ten of Pentacles energy is something that lasts, something that's really successful. It's two people that want to be with each other and nobody else, but it's sitting right next to the High Priestess for your person. So for that Ten of Pentacles, Virgo energy, High Priestess, I also get Virgo, Cancer, and Pisces, me as a reader, but it's a quiet energy. The High Priestess is very quiet. So it's like this person is thinking about you. They're thinking about this potential, this long-term potential, what it would be like to be with you. We have the Ten of Cups also in the bottom of the deck, but they're being very quiet about it, especially with that Page of Swords energy. They're feeling you out. They're wanting to know. I almost feel like they don't want to freak you out too much. Like they think about messages and they think about all these things they want to say, but they take it kind of slow because they don't want to overwhelm you. At their final two cards, or the Page of Cups and the Page of Pentacles. This is somebody making a move. They could even use like a Happy New Year or something like that as a chance to reach out to you. There's so much more behind it, but I feel like they want to start small and take their time and see where this can go. And you're in a very similar energy here, Leo. So the two of you are both feeling this. Look at this, the Page of Pentacles and the Page of Cups. That's wanting to be together, wanting to meet up, maybe go on a date, maybe feel this out, maybe see what the potential is. But there's some fun, there's some flirtation, there's some lightheartedness, and there is some absolutely beautiful news with that Sun card. I love it for you, Leo. I love this for all the Leos that I know and love. I'm excited to see some good things happening for you coming up here in January. So I want to thank you all so much. If you enjoyed the reading, I'd love you to put a like on it. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. If something spoke to you and you'd like to reach out for a personal reading, I would love to hear from you. And Spirit is telling me, clarify that Page of Swords. So I'm going to go for it. Oh my gosh. And we have the Four of Pentacles again. This person is holding on to you. Wow. But they have the Six of Wands. That's Leo energy. That's somebody wanting to come in. Definitely wanting to take some steps towards you. But look what we have. When I was getting ready to wrap up, I thought, you know, I didn't do any clarifiers and I want to do one for you. I decided to clarify what is going on in this person's heart. What are they overthinking about with the Page of Swords? And I got the King of Cups. Leo, they have fallen for you. Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces energy could be significant, but this person's feelings definitely are a lot stronger than you know. And I'm not even sure they realized that they were going to feel this way, but they do. And now they want to do something about it. I love it for you. Beautiful. So thank you all so much. Once again, Happy New Year. Feel free to reach out for personal reading if you would like. My website is charitygenise.com. I love you all so much and I'll talk to you soon.